Hello, hello. Welcome to Top Shelf Backpacking. Just wanted to let you know that today is July 1st. Normally, it is a Saturday, so normally I'd be posting a bloopers video. Somehow I made it all the way through June without any mistakes. Not sure how that happened, but trust me, I will, if I deem it's worth the bloopers reel, I will be editing it into one, so there's likely going to be some stuff come August. Also, if you've been missing peanut butter pairings, it is on indefinite hiatus. Just allow me more time to get out on adventure, film more backpacking and whiskey content for you guys. 40 episodes was quite a ride. Thank you to Bourbon Lover from Arizona on TikTok for the kind of idea. It was a wild ride. Tried a lot of gross things. A couple good ones, but we may pick it up in the future. But for now, you will find other content on the weekends. Today I'd like to show you some recycled reviews, some of the things I finished quarter two of 2023, and we will start with the non-whiskey ones first. We have this El Padrino Tequila Lime Cream, recommended by One Big Pikey on TikTok and Instagram. Fantastic over ice. Couldn't really find much to mix it with, but I mean, it was great on its own. Bottle lasted a couple weeks. Next up is Fluorescence from Heritage Distilling out of, I think they have distilleries in both Oregon and Washington, recommended by my friend Roxy. I think we cracked this guy open on a Saturday night. By Sunday, it was gone. It is a fantastic grapefruit and pomelo flavored vodka. Made some really good cocktails, great over ice, fantastic pour. After that, we have another kind of cocktail in a glass. This is Rock and Rye from Crater Lake Spirits. Kind of a sweet whiskey cocktail, 30 proof, so packs a good punch, great over ice or on its own. Might be replacing that one. It was kind of nice to have some. I could just pour, garnish if you wanted to, or not. Goes down nice and easy. Next up, we have a rum. This is Kirk and Sweeney. Kirk and Sweeney makes some of my favorite rums. This Reserva, not my favorite. I want to say it's bottom or mid-tier in their lineup now. They used to be age-stated, now they're not. Plantation 5-star for the price is better in my opinion, but I still like some of their older stuff from Kirk and Sweeney. Now we get into the whiskeys. First off, we have Elijah Craig Barrel Proof A120. This one lasted me 3 years, obviously, there. Got it in 2020. Chased the Elijah Craig Barrel Proof thing. Kept showing up on people's top 10 lists every year. Picked up a few different bottles, and although they're not bad and they're a great value for a barrel proof, definitely not my go-to, so it takes a while to drink them down, but I do have two others in the bar ready for consumption. My go-to whiskey for people trying to get into whiskey, TX Blended. This will get refilled by my 175, so it'll fit in the bar. I always keep that stuff on hand. I wouldn't dare ever run out. A lot of my friends really enjoy it. Sweet and easy. It's like melted vanilla ice cream. Goes great with orange soda, root beer, Coke. Great neat on its own. Really sweet and approachable. One of my favorite whiskeys. Already got its replacement. Next up, we have Ardbeg Wee Beastie. This is their five-year-old expression. At first, didn't really care for it. It seemed kind of brash and harsh, but after it opened up for a while, I mean, I probably made it through the second half of the bottle in like a month. Really good Isla notes. That $50 to $55 price range is really good. I think I'll probably pick up like a Korevecin or an Ugadal to replace it, or maybe I'll save a few bucks and I'll buy another Wee Beastie. We will see. The Glenross Vintage Reserve. Had this for quite a few years. It was the first scotch that kind of got me into the Speysides to see just how sweet and, oh, say bourbon-ish a scotch could be. Fantastic offering. I'll probably replace it with their bourbon cask, as from what I hear, that's the closest to the Vintage Reserve there. The final one, and the one I'm most sad about, is the Devil's Bit. This is the 2023 St. Patrick's Day special release, picked up for me by the Black Hat Fan Club, and it is a really good Oregon single malt. Spicy, there's bits of citrus in there, five-year-old, all Oregon. Such a fantastic whiskey. I hope I or one of my friends can pick me up a bottle next year, because this stuff is just so nice to have. So that's a short review of everything I had quarter two of 2023. We'll see what the summer may bring. Maybe some more non-whiskeys. Time will tell. Hopefully I can find some more of this Fluorescence, because this was incredible. Great summertime drink. But until I see you all again, cheers.